Hello students, welcome to our today's class. In this today's class we are going to focus on the what are aromatic compounds, anti-aromatic compounds and non-aromatic compounds. In detailed manner and in simple way we will discuss about this concept. So here see, after this class you never get any mistake while solving the questions related to the aromatic, anti-aromatic, non-aromatic. So let's get into our class. The first point, everyone should have clarity on the what are aromatic compounds. We know very well, every student if you take, they have some clarity on the aromatic compounds. So aromatic compound means it should satisfy four rules or four points. You can take that is, first one is here, you can remember like this. Here see. C, P, next one, C, fourth one, H. So if any compound, if it want to be aromatic, it should satisfy these four, C, P, C, H. What is C, sir? The first one you see, first C is cyclic. So the compound must be cyclic. Next P is what, sir? Planar. The compound must be planar. Next C is what, sir? Conjugation. Okay, so conjugation you have to take like this, conjugation. Next one is what, sir? Huckel rule. Huckel rule. So any compound want to be aromatic compound, it should satisfy these four points. Okay, so everyone knows this, but in this also you should have clarity on these topics. Okay, so first one, cyclic means you know it should contain in the cycle mode, not a open chain, it must be cyclic. This one is very simple. Next one you see, this one it must be planar, means here you see this point, if it want to be planar, the carbons which are in the ring or any element which is present in the ring, it should contain what? sp2 hybridization. In the ring, the element either may be carbon or any other than carbon, they should involve in the what? sp2 hybridization. Then only it is possible planar, then only we can consider it as like that ring is planar. So first point is what? The compound must be cyclic. Cyclic means it should contain, it is in the form of a ring. Okay, so ring means two ends connected with each other. Okay, so here it must be a planar. Planar means in the ring, what we have discussed, so in the ring the carbons or any other atoms present, they should involve in the sp2 hybridization. Have you got it? So next point is very, very important. Conjugation. Okay, so what is meant by conjugation? So conjugation between what? Here you see, conjugation alternative positions, you should have clarity here. Point number one, that is here you see, pi bond, sigma bond and pi bond. So pi and sigma conjugate with each other. So pi bond, sigma, pi. So this is one type of arrangement of conjugation. So second type of conjugation you can take like this. What is that? Pi bond, sigma bond, or you can take sometimes negative charge will be given. Pi bond, sigma bond, negative charge. Or we can also take it as like a lone pair. These are in the conjugation. Okay, so next one, next conjugation pattern if you see, we can also consider pi bond, sigma bond and positive charge on the carbon or anything, right? So here it should be cyclic and it should be planar. That means thus in the cycle the atom which is present, it must possess that hybridization, must be in sp2 hybridization. Next one, conjugation, that arrangement of bonds are negative charge or positive charge must be in this pattern, that is positive sorry, that is pi bond sigma pi. Pi sigma negative or lone pair. Pi sigma positive charge. So like this type of alternative position. The conjugation must be like this. And next one, Huckel's rule. Everyone knows about this. Huckel's rule is 4n plus 2 pi electrons. The compound should contain 4n plus 2 pi electrons. That means what? Here n value, this is very very important point. So the compound should contain 4n plus 2 pi electrons. Here n value, n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, like that you can take n value. Okay, so if a given compound satisfies these four rules, one is cyclic, it must be a planar, it should have conjugation, and it should follow Huckel's rule, which is equal to 4n plus 2 pi electrons. Here n value should be taken like this. Have you got it? 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. So if that compound, such compounds, we can consider it as like a aromatic compound. So after these points, what do we have to do is, after, if you have complete idea, so we take our familiar example for the aromatic compound. Okay, so here see, is it clear? Any doubt in this? Okay, done. Now what we are going to do is, I am going to give you one example which is familiar, you know very well, that is called as benzene. Okay, so we do many examples, nearly 15 examples, 15 examples we are going to solve in this class. So now here you see the familiar example for the aromatic compound, you know, this is benzene. You can take like this, just you take like this. So in this, now we are going to check, is it aromatic or not? Yes, it is 100% aromatic. How can you say? First C, what is that C? Cyclic. It is a cyclic. Yes, first one, okay. Second one, so it is a planar. Yeah, we can say it confidently. Each carbon is involving in the sp2 hybridization. You can check it. So that's why it is a planar. Next, here conjugation. You see this conjugation here, pi sigma pi. This conjugation is there. So therefore, we can say it is in the conjugation. Have you got it? So next one is Huckel rule. Huckel rule means what? You know, 4n plus 2 pi electrons. Here see, in that n is equal to 0, if you substitute, how many pi electrons will come? 2 pi electrons will come. If n is equal to 1, you substitute, here this is n is equal to 0. If n is equal to 1, if you substitute, here what is coming here? 6 pi electrons. That means 4 into 1 plus 2. Pi electrons. Therefore, what we are getting here is 6 pi electrons. 6 pi electrons means how many bonds? One bond contains 2 electrons. 6 pi electrons means 3 bonds, 3 pi bonds. 1, 2, 3. So we can say it is following Huckel's rule also. So 4 steps satisfied by the benzene. So benzene, we can consider it as like it is a example of what? Major example we'll take according to our syllabus. So this is a aromatic compound. It is a aromatic compound. Okay. So it is a aromatic compound. Do you have any doubt in this? Okay, done. So after these points, we need to talk about anti-aromatic. So now what we are going to discuss is anti-aromatic compounds. You take this one. Very simple way we will discuss. You see, first three satisfied. Anti-aromatic compounds, first three satisfied. But last one is not followed. That means last one not followed. Instead of Huckel's rule, they follow 4n pi electrons. Very simple way you have to have clarity on this. What is this? Here you see anti-aromatic compounds. Aromatic compounds. So what is the difference between these two? What is the difference is very simple. The number of pi electrons difference. Remaining everything is same. Number of pi electrons only differ. Here aromatic compounds contain 4n plus 2 pi electrons. You know very well Huckel's rule. But anti-aromatic compounds contains only 4n pi electrons. These three same, similar both cases. Have you got it? Next, number of electrons, number of pi electrons only differ here. Such type of compounds, we can call it as like anti-aromatic compounds. Sir, can you give one example? Yeah, definitely you can take this example. What is this example? Here you see this. Here, this is, we can take this one, cyclobutene. Okay, you can take like this, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So here check it one by one. Is it following this first three or not? Is it cycle or not? Yes, it is a cycle. So first C, okay. Next, is it planar or not? Yes, we have to check it. It is a planar. How, sir? How will it be planar? Because the carbons which are present in the ring involving in the sp2 hybridization. Next, third one, conjugation. Yeah, it is following conjugation also. Which type of conjugation? Pi sigma pi, pi sigma pi. Okay, so therefore this is called as conjugation. Next one is Huckel rule. Huckel rule it is not following. Why? Because it is having how many electrons? Here see, how many, just you see this. Here n value starts from, very important, 1, 2, 3 and so on. Okay, here n value should not be taken 0. Okay, so right. Okay, so in this 4n pi electrons, n is equal to 1, you substitute, how many electrons will come? 4 electrons. Okay, so it is containing how many pi electrons? 4 pi electrons are present. So 4 pi electrons are not coming under Huckel's rule. Okay, see Huckel's rule start. First number, 2 pi electrons, second number, 6 pi electrons, third number, like that we can take it. But these 4 electrons are not belongs to come under Huckel's rule, are not coming under Huckel's rule. So therefore what can we say here? We can say this compound is one example for the what, anti-aromatic compounds. Here students, again you focus here. Aromatic compounds means which follows these 4. Okay, CpCH. Okay, but anti-aromatic compound means it follows CpC but not H. Instead of Huckel rule, they contain 4n pi electrons. Have you got it? So you take this example. This is belongs to what, anti-aromatic compounds. Okay, so now I want to tell you the next one, which is very very important, non-aromatic compound. See here, non-aromatic compound. In this case, if you take non-aromatic compound, non-aromatic compound. So if you take non-aromatic compound, so if you take that, very simple, very very simple. It is failing, the compound which is not following these three, any one of these three, the compound which is not following any one of these three, then that compound we can call it as like a what, and non-aromatic compound. That is called as what? Non-aromatic compound. Very simple. The compound which is not following any one of the first three. Any one of the first three. Then we can call it as like what? Non-aromatic compound. First three follows. Last one is not followed. which contains 4n pi electrons. That is anti-aromatic compound. Whereas coming to this third type, that is nothing but a non-aromatic compounds, in the first three only it fails. Okay, so it may contain number of electrons equal to Hückel rule, or may contain different. Okay, so here the point is, in non-aromatic compounds, they fail in the first three only. C, P, C, in these three only it fails. So such compounds we have to consider it as like a non-aromatic compounds. Okay, so I want to give you here one example. You take this simple example, you will get it clearly. Here, this one, you take it. You take this one. What is this? So one triangle is nothing but one cycle. So this is cyclopropene. Okay, I have taken this one. Is it cycle or not? Yes, it is a cycle. The first point is okay, satisfied. Second point, you see this. Second point, what is its hybridization? Hybridization here sp2 sp2, and here it is what? sp3 hybridization. So if it is sp3, it won't come under planar. Okay, so first one okay, second one it's not coming under planar, it's not a planar. Third one, you see third one, conjugation, is there any conjugation? Check it once. Pi sigma sigma, so that is not coming under conjugation pattern. So pi sigma sigma, this is not coming under, so it is not following conjugation also. Next, I already told you it fails, non-aromatic compound fails to follow any one of the first three or three also. Okay, so then here you see cyclic, okay, what is this? Planar failed. And next one, what is this? Conjugation fail. Next, fourth one, once you check it here, in this 2 pi electrons are there. Okay, it may follow this Hückel rule or may not. Okay, so here you can take. Finally, what can we say? It is an example of what? Non-aromatic compound. Non-aromatic compound. So this is the concept behind it. So simply we have to learn. Okay, don't get confused or this and that and all those things not needed. Very simple. Four follows, then aromatic. First three follows, last one is not followed, and it is following 4n pi electrons. Anti-aromatic. Okay, so first three, in the first three anyone fail or all fail, that is coming under non-aromatic. That is anti-aromatic, this is non-aromatic. Okay, sometimes they follow Hückel's rule, this one, that is not an issue for us. In the first three, any one it is not following, or two or three are not following, then it is taken as like non-aromatic compound. Up to here, clear? Any doubt in this? Okay. After this, next I want to give you clarity about this stability of these compounds. Is it clear? Take it down clearly. Any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Definitely I will give you a reply. Okay, so after this point here, what we are going to focus is the stability and the types of reactions involving. So now first what I am going to tell you is stability. Very, very important about this point, stability point. So order of stability. Now, these concepts are very important for JEE purpose and NEET purpose also. See, stability, first one, aromatic compounds, if you take, they are more stable. Next, you can take non-aromatic compounds. Next one is non-aromatic compounds. You can take like this. Okay, have you got it? Next one. Here, least stable or super unstable. We can call it as like a super unstable. Okay, those are nothing but a anti-aromatic. anti-aromatic compounds. Aromatic, anti-aromatic compounds. So this is order of stability. Okay, so we have to have clarity. This is order of stability. Order of stability. Okay, so now here you take this stability. I think you may get one doubt here. What is the reason why these anti-aromatic compounds are least stable? Here, I don't want to go in detail manner, just I want to give you one clue. This reason can be explained with the help of molecular orbital theory. Okay, so molecular orbital theory, which is not given in our syllabus. Okay, so here there is some bonding molecular orbital, anti-bonding, non-bonding molecular orbital. With the help of the molecular orbital theory, we can give clarity why these anti-aromatic compounds are unstable. But that is not at all belongs to our syllabus. We are not involving into that molecular orbital theory. So now here see, now only I told you, these anti-aromatic compounds are super unstable. So due to this super unstable, what is happening? Very, very important here. That is due to super unstable, these anti-aromatic compounds, anti-aromatic compounds are converting into what? Converting into either aromatic or non-aromatic. Very important point this one. Here very, very important point this one. Here you see anti-aromatic compounds are super unstable. Due to super unstable of anti-aromatic compounds, what is happening here? They don't want to stay in the state of anti-aromatic compounds. They want to convert, to get stabilized. Okay, they convert into aromatic, or they may convert into non-aromatic compounds. Okay, so these points are very, very important. You should have clarity on this. Is it clear? Now what we are going to discuss is which type of reactions these compounds are involving in, the which type of reactions. Here we have to have clarity on the one by one. Here see, reactions involving at normal conditions. Reactions involving in the normal conditions. First of all, if you take, first I want to point out this one, that is anti-aromatic compounds, they are unstable, that's why they involve in the dimerization. They involve in the dimerization reactions. They involve in the dimerization reactions. Have you got it? So coming to this one, what is this? Non-aromatic. Anti-aromatic compounds are involving in the dimerization reactions to get stability. Anti-aromatic compounds always try to get stability. That's the point. Next one, if you take non-aromatic compounds. Non-aromatic compounds mean generally they involve in the electrophilic addition reactions. Electrophilic addition reactions. We have to have clarity on this. Electrophilic addition reactions. Okay, so electrophilic addition reactions. Now coming to here, these aromatic compounds, here these are involving in the electrophilic substitution reactions. Electrophilic substitution reactions. That means what is this? Here you have to have clarity. Chemical normal conditions at room temperature or general conditions. These are in first one aromatic compound, if you take, they involve in the electrophilic substitution reactions. And non-aromatic compounds, if you take here, they are involving in the electrophilic addition reactions. If you take anti-aromatic compounds, they are involving in the dimerization reactions. Is it clear? So this is the major points of this total three types. Up to here, we have a clear-cut idea about aromatic and anti-aromatic and non-aromatic, their process and everything, their stabilities and all. So now what we are going to do is, generally in organic chemistry, theory part, everyone knows theory part. But no use if you learn only theory part, no use. Okay, you have to apply that command which you have on the theory while solving the problems or while solving the examples. Then your concept will become more strong. So we are going to solve various examples. You will get complete command. So now we solve some questions on this concept. So first one, you can see this. First example, one by one. Very interesting examples we are going to solve. And I want to give you clear explanation on the each example. See this, first one, first example number one. Here I am taking this comp one. They gave like this. Okay, so here you see this one, simply. Okay, you take this one. In this, what we are going to, what is this? Is it aromatic or not? One by one we have to see. First one, is it satisfying? First one, is it satisfying cyclic? Yes, it is a cycle. We don't have any problem. Okay, next, you see this next one? Next one. Here, the next one is it what, planar or not? It is a planar. Why? Because each carbon is involving in the what? sp2 hybridization, and sometimes it may be sp also. Okay, so here you see that is also planar. What is linear? No, planar. So that's why. Next one, here is it conjugation, is it involving in the conjugation or not? Pi bond sigma positive. Yeah, it is a conjugation, no? We have discussed. Here see now, pi bond sigma positive, positive sigma pi, pi sigma pi. So it is in the conjugation. So now this one also okay. Next one is fourth one. What is the fourth one? Here is it following what, Haeckel's rule or not? Just you check. How many pi bonds are there? Pi bonds means two pi bonds. Each pi bond contains two pi electrons. How many pi electrons are there here? These four pi electrons are there. So if four pi electrons are present, means is it following Haeckel's rule or not? Haeckel rule means what? 4n plus 2 pi electrons. 4n plus 2 pi electrons means, here n is equal to 0, 2 pi electrons. N is equal to 1, 6 pi electrons. But here what did you get? 4 pi electrons. So it is not following Haeckel's rule. Okay, is it clear? I think you may get one doubt here. This is positive charge. Positive charge means here it is not having any electrons. So simply we can say first three followed this compound. Last one it is not following. It is following four, it is containing four pi electrons. Four pi electrons means what? It is simply following 4n pi electrons. So simply we can say here it is a anti-aromatic compound. It is an anti-aromatic compound. Okay, so here very very important point, aromatic compound. Is it clear? Any doubt in this? And one more thing here. Okay, is it clear? So done. You take it, this one. Okay, here next. After this, we can take one more. So one more example we are going to take. That is same, just I am changing a small point here. Here, this is very simple and excellent one. So same thing I have taken. So now check it one by one. First one is what? Is it cycle or not? Yes, sir, it is a cycle. Okay, next one. What is the next one? Here, next one is 2. 2 is what? Is it in conjugate? Is it planar or not? So most of the people are getting confused in this point. Getting confused in this point. That means here, see, if it want to be planar, that the carbon which is involving, the carbon which is present in the ring, it must be sp2 hybridization. But here negative charge one, generally all are taking, that is sp3, that is not sp3 hybridization. It is not involving in the sp3. It is involving in the sp2 hybridization. Why? Because, sir, what is the reason? This lone pair of electron or nothing but a negative charge is not at all stable. Okay, it's not at all localized. It is delocalized. Delocalized means what? Here, this negative charge is revolving or moving, involving in the resonance. So, or what? Involving in the delocalization. So, that's why this carbon also coming under sp2 hybridization. Okay. So, if it is present, that negative charge is present only on that carbon, it come under sp3. But it is not involved, may not present on this carbon. It is involving in the what? Delocalization. So that's why what is happening, this carbon also invert mean this carbon involving in the sp2 hybridization, very very important. So all must be in the sp2, therefore we can say what is this? Planar. Have you got it? Planar. Now coming to this one, third one. What is the third one? Third one is it involving in the conjugation? Yes, it is involving in the conjugation. Pi sigma negative. Negative sigma pi. Pi sigma pi. So it is involving in the conjugation. Okay. So right. Next one. Fourth point. Is it having 6 pi electrons? You must remember. Pi electrons means pi bonded electrons and lone pairs. Very very important. Here see. Pi electrons is equal to what? Pi bonded electrons and you can take lone pairs. So this is one of the very 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 important point. So now while calculating electrons, two pi bonds means 4 pi electrons. Okay, 4 pi electrons and one lone pair. Those are also we consider as like a pi electron. So total how many we are getting here? 6 pi electrons. Have you got it or not? 6 pi electrons. Is it clear? Very very important point this one. Take it down this. So it is following 6 pi electrons means it is following Huckel's rule. Okay, so it is coming under which compound? Aromatic compound. You take it like this, aromatic. So all satisfied. Again I am saying, the lone pair which is present on the carbon, if it is local means it is not moving, if it is local, we can say here that carbon atom involving in the sp3. But the lone pair which is involving, or the negative charge which is present on the carbon involving in the delocalization, that lone pair or negative charge is not taken in the hybridization. That is why here that hybridization of this carbon, we take it as like a sp2. Have you got it? Very very important point. Okay, so up to here clear? This point you should have clarity. Okay, it is general way. If you see, sp3 will come, it is not general case. Why? This lone pair is involving in the delocalization, or this negative charge is involving in the delocalization. Whenever it is involving in the delocalization, we should not take that delocalized negative charge or lone pair in the hybridization. So therefore, this hybridization is sp2 hybridization. Okay, we take next example. Okay, so you can take this next example. Right. So coming to the next example, this is also very interesting. You should have clarity on this. So now, what is this one? Just you see, third example, that is, I am taking this one here, and here upside we are taking here their positive charge. Now tell me, what is this? Is it aromatic, anti-aromatic, non-aromatic? Very simple. You have to have a clarity in this case. What is this? First, is it cycle or not? Yes, it is satisfying the first point, C, cyclic. Next, second one, is it planar or not? It is not planar. Why? Yeah, this is sp2, this is sp2, okay. But whereas coming to these points, it is not sp2, it is sp3, and this carbon atom also sp3. So it is not a planar. If it is cycle, even though it is cycle, it is not a planar. Next, third one, is it in the conjugation? Now check it, pi sigma sigma. So it is not in conjugation. Now it is not in conjugation. Now fourth one you take. This fourth one is what? Simply we can say it contains 2 pi electrons. If it follows maybe Huckel rule, but it is not what? Aromatic. What is this? It is a non-aromatic compound. It is a non-aromatic compound. Yeah, you can take like this. Okay. Next, fourth example. You try this one, fourth example, and tell me. Okay. I'm not giving any names of this one because I don't want to confuse you again with respect to names. You can practice later. Now here you see this. Negative charge means you can take one lone pair. You can take like this. So first, one by one you check it. Which type of compound is it? Is it cycle or not? First one. You see this? Yes. Yes, sir. It is a cycle. Done. Now, is it planar or not? Very, very important. Is it planar or not? Yes, sir. It is planar. Why, sir? Why? What is the reason? Pi sigma negative charge. Okay. So next, pi sigma negative charge. Pi sigma positive. Pi sigma. It is in the what? Simple what? According to our what? Conjugation. It is in the conjugation. Okay. So you keep it like that. It is in the conjugation. But what about planar, sir? Planar. Yes. It is in the planar only. This is sp2, and this is also sp2. We have discussed in the second example, sp2. So all are sp2. This is coming under what? What is this? Here, cyclic, planar, and what is this? Conjugation. And fourth one, is it following Huckel's rule? Yes, it is following Huckel's rule. What is this? 2 pi and 1 lone pair. Negative charge means 1 lone pair. So therefore, we can say total 4 electrons plus 2. Okay. So 6 pi electrons, which is following Huckel's rule. This example, we can take it as like a aromatic compound. Aromatic compound. You can take it like this. Is it clear? So now, fifth example we are going to take here. Fifth example. Okay, so just fifth example, I want to change this one very simply. Is it clear? Any doubt? It's a cyclic, it is a planar because all carbon atoms are involving in the sp2 hybridization, and it is in the conjugation we discussed, and it contains 6 pi electrons, 2 plus 4, 6 pi electrons, which is Huckel's rule following. Now here you see a simple change I want to do in this example. Okay, so third one, fourth one, next fifth one you take. Fifth one. Just you see this fifth one. Okay, so what about this one you tell me now. Now tell me, is it what type of? Same example, yeah. just. Here you see this, it is a cycle, okay, done sir. It is a planar, is it planar? No, it is involving in the sp3 hybridization. It is involving in the sp3 hybridization. So it is not a planar. Now is it in the conjugation? No, it is not in the conjugation. Okay, that means pi sigma sigma is coming, not in the conjugation. Now you take this one, Huckel, is it following Huckel rule? No, it is not following Huckel rule. So because it is containing only four pi electrons, so we can say here, what is this? It is a non-aromatic compound. Non-aromatic compound. You can take like this, non-aromatic compound. Is it clear? Now coming to the next one, fifth one. Okay, this is fifth one. Now we can take sixth example. Now in this sixth example, you can take very, very interesting and important example. So what is that? You can familiar heterocyclic compound, that is nothing but a furan. Okay, done. This is furan. You can know, familiar, no? That's what I mean. Furan. So now is it aromatic or not? We need to check it. Here you see this. First one. Yes, it is a cyclic compound. Yes, it is a cyclic. Next, second one. After cyclic, is it planar or not? Is it planar or not? How can we say based on hybridization? sp2 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 sp2. Okay, so total sp, this is also sp2, the oxygen which is present here. Sir, how can you say sir it is sp2? It is sp3, no? Okay, so generally we say like that. How can we say here? Because this one lone pair which is alignment or parallel to the pi bond, one is not parallel to the pi bond. So this is not involving in the delocalization and this is involving in the delocalization. Okay, so here you see, while calculating hybridization of the element, the delocalized lone pair cannot be taken or cannot be considered in the hybridization. So here you see this, what, two bonds and one lone pair, that means it is coming under sp2 only. Have you got it? So here this is also coming under sp2 hybridization, because this the one lone pair is involving in the delocalization, so therefore it is a planar. Next, third one is conjugation. You see here, this lone pair, one lone pair only involved in the conjugation. Why not second one, sir? Second one, here see, one lone pair aligned, mean parallel to the pi orbital. Pi bond means pi orbital. So pi orbital overlap, side wise overlap. This lone pair is parallel to the what? Parallel to the pi orbital. So that's why it is involving. It is not parallel. So that's why this lone pair is not involving. You should have clarity. So now it is in the conjugation or not, you check it. Pi sigma lone pair. Lone pair sigma pi. Yeah, pi sigma pi. So it is in the conjugation. Have you got it what I am saying here? Now here coming to the number of electron pairs. Sir, you said, okay, what? Pi bonded electrons plus lone pair. Lone pair means which is involving in the delocalization, that only we consider here. Have you got it? So therefore, how many electron pairs are there? Total 1, 2 plus 2, this 2 plus 1, total how many? 6. Is it clear? 6 you can take. This is we are not taking because it is not at all involving in the what? Hybridization, or nothing but a, it is not involving the delocalization. So therefore we can say here 6 pi electrons are present, which is following Huckel's rule. So therefore this is considered as like a aromatic compound. Is it clear? So take it down clearly. Okay, any doubt in this, one by one you check it. Right. Next, coming to the one more example. You can take one more example. What is that? You can have it. Right. So next one, you see this. Same, similar, you have to solve this. Next example. This is also familiar. Okay, so this is pi rule. Pi rule. So in this pi rule, here you see it. First, is it following first step? Yes, sir. It is following first one. Yes. Is it? It is a cyclic. It is a cycle compound. Okay. So it is a cycle. Next one. Is it involving in the what? Is it planar or not? We need to have an idea on that. Yes, it is a planar. SP2, 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 SP2. Here it is involving in the delocalization. So here also this nitrogen, okay, SP2 hybridization. So final, why? Because here see, this lone pair is not at all in the localized state. It is in the delocalized. So therefore it is also SP2. So it's totally what? Planar. All are in the SP2 hybridization. It is in the planar. Now coming to the next one. Next one is what? Conjugation. Is it involving in the conjugation? Yes, sir. One, what is what? Pi. Here pi, sigma, and one more thing is lone pair. Pi, sigma, lone pair. Pi, sigma, pi. So it is in the conjugation. Now you can check it here clearly. Here, number of electron pairs. Here it is involving. No, that's why we have to take this one into the water. Our number of pi electrons. Okay, so pi, 2 pi bonds means 4 pi electrons and 1 lone pair. Total how many? 6 pi electrons. 6 pi electrons. So this, it is following Hockel's rule. So therefore you can say it is a aromatic. It is a aromatic compound. Aromatic compound. You can take it like this. Aromatic compound. And next, one more excellent example you can take here. Here you see. Here, this is our example. Is it aromatic or not? Or non-aromatic or anti-aromatic? You have to calculate this one. Generally, if you take this example, you cannot find it out. What is this? It is looking like this. Here, simply, it is in the equilibrium with its ionic state. You can take like this. So, you have to convert this one. This manner. Like, so this is moving towards this side due to high electronegativity. So this is pi, 0 means so oxygen negative charge and it is positive. Now here you see, all of you, here one important point. So we need to calculate only in the cycle. We need not to think about this outside elements, electrons and all. So here you check it. Now this, in this example, okay, so in this example, is it aromatic or not, or non-aromatic or anti-aromatic? First one, check it here. Is it cycle or not? Yes, sir, it is cycle. 1, 2, 3. It is a cycle. Yeah, we don't have any problem. It is a cycle. Okay, next one. Is it planar or not? Yes, it is a planar. SP2, SP2, SP2. It's a planar. Next, third one, you see this. Is it in the conjugation or not? See, pi, what is this? What is this? Sigma, positive charge. So it is in the conjugation. So we can get it simply. Pi, sigma, positive charge. It is in the conjugation. Next one, you can take. Next, is it contain, is it following Hockel's rule? Yes, it is following Hockel's rule, because how many pi bonds are there? Only one. One means 2 pi electrons. 2 pi electrons means Hockel rule only. Yes, 2 pi electrons. So it is following Hockel's rule. So therefore, what can we say? It is also aromatic compound. Aromatic compound. It is also aromatic compound. Okay, so right. Take it down these examples. Next, one more example I want to give you here. Is it clear? Any doubt in this? Okay. Next one. Next example. Very, very interesting and excellent example we are going to solve here. Right. Now, here you see this. We are taking simply so this is the compound. One, two, yeah, we'll take like this. So is it aromatic or anti-aromatic or non-aromatic? Very important here, this example. You see, generally, is it one by one we have to check? No, you have to check it easily one by one. First one, yes, it is a cycle. Yes, okay. Is it planar or not? Yes, it is a planar because all are involving in the what? What? sp2 hybridization planar. Planar means two dimensional, 2D structure. Okay, now next one. Is it in the conjugation or not? Yes, it is in the conjugation. That means what is this? Pi sigma pi. Pi sigma pi. Okay, pi sigma pi pi sigma. Yeah, so it is in the conjugation. Next, what is this? Here, number of pi bonds. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 means what? 4. So 4 means 8 pi electrons. 4 pi bonds means you have to multiply with 2 electrons. No? So 8 pi electrons. 8 pi electrons means 4n pi electrons it is contained. That means n is equal to you substitute. So, it is not following Huckel's rule, okay, because it is containing what? 8 pi electrons. Can you see this? No. 8 pi electrons, which means it is following first 3, not last 1. So, therefore, you can say this one is what? It is a anti-aromatic. Anti-aromatic, or we can also call it as like a anti-aromatic. No problem. anti-aromatic compound. But here in the some books they did not mention anti-aromatic compound, they mentioned non-aromatic compound. Why? What is the reason? You know very well these anti-aromatic compounds are unstable, so due to unstable they convert into where to where, either aromatic or what? Non-aromatic. So here due to instability of anti-aromatic compound, this compound structure, that means planar, will become non-planar. Okay, so here it is becoming like this. It is becoming like this. Is it clear? So here it is because of its instability. It is very important example. It is unstable. Okay. It's an anti-aromatic compound. That's why to get stability, it twists 2D to 3D. This is 3D. So whenever it is existing in 3D, it is getting stability and it is converting into non-aromatic compound. Non-aromatic compound. Have you got it or not? Okay, non-aromatic compound. Is it clear? Any doubt in this? So it's a nice example, you have to take it in. Okay, so right. Now coming to the next, one more. Next example, one more we can take. Next one more example we can take here. Right. So you know very well, naphthalene. Okay, so next example I am taking here. So I think you see naphthalene I am taking. Huh? Okay, so this is a naphthalene. Now check it. One by one you can take. First one, naphthalene. Is it cycle or not? Yes, it's a cycle. Okay. Next one is what? You can take one more thing. Is it a planar or not? Yes, it is a planar. How can I say? Because each carbon is involving in the sp2 hybridization. It's a planar. Okay. Next one. What is that next one? Here you see this. Here, so in the conjugation, yeah, check it once. Pi sigma pi, pi sigma pi, like that. It is in the conjugation. So, right. Next one, fourth one. Is it following Huckel's rule or not? You know, 4n plus 2 pi electrons. In this, n is equal to 2, you substitute. N is equal to 2 means 8 plus 2, that is 10 pi electrons. That is 10 pi electrons. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 bonds means 5 into 2, 10 pi electrons. 10 pi electrons means here you can say that is a 10 pi electrons which is following Huckel's. Therefore, we can say it is a aromatic compound. You can give clarity like this. Aromatic compound. Okay. So, aromatic compound. Is it clear? Now, one more excellent example is there. That example is very, 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 very important. Take it down this one. After this, next one. Biphenyls and triphenyls. So now, I am taking here biphenyls. So biphenyls, you can take like this. Simply biphenyls. Okay, so if you take biphenyls, this is, you can also take triphenyl. So this is biphenyl. Okay, done. So now what we are going to do now, just you check it. So is it cycle? One by one you have to check it here. Is it cycle? Yes, it's a cycle. It's a cyclic. You can take it like this. And next, is it planar? Yes, it is a planar. Okay, it is a planar. Why? Because all are involving in the sp2 hybridization. Next, you can take third one. Third one, is it involving in the conjugation? Yes, it is involving in the conjugation. Okay, right. But now, is it following Huckel's rule or not? You have to check here. That is 6 pi means 6 pi bonds. 6 pi bonds means what? 12 pi electrons. 12 pi electrons, which is not following Huckel's rule. Not following Huckel's rule. Okay, they are having what, 12 pi electrons, but it is not following Huckel's rule. So, based on the rules, we can say what it is a, what anti-aromatic. But it's a wrong thing, not anti-aromatic. Very important point this is also. Okay. It's not an anti-aromatic. It's an aromatic compound. It's an aromatic compound. According to this is one exception. We should have clarity on this. Generally, if you take like this, it is coming under anti-aromatic. But here see, actually it's a characteristics. If you observe, it shows aromatic in nature. Why, sir? What is the reason? It's an aromatic compound, I am saying. But how can you say this? You have to have an idea on this important point. So it is aromatic. How can means two rings which are aromatic, if they connect with one single bond, they can act as like a aromatic compounds. Two rings which are aromatic, which are connected, two rings which are acting or which are aromatic nature, which are in the aromatic nature, if they connect with single bond, this is that example also coming under. That total compound is coming under aromatic in nature. Have you got it? Even according to rules, it is an anti-aromatic, but its nature is aromatic compound only. Have you got it? So this ring, not only this one, you can take one more ring here. One more ring here, like that. Whatever you take. So two aromatic rings or three aromatic rings are connected with each other. Okay, then what is happening? That should be taken it as like aromatic compound. We should not go like this. If you go according to the rules which we have learned, it is giving anti-aromatic. That is not at all correct in this case. This is exceptional case. Have you got it? Take it down this one clearly. And last one more example is there. I want to give you that example to you. If you learn about that example here, this total class will be over. Okay, so right. Now you take this example. This is excellent example. Excellent example. You can take this one. What is this? Here you see this. In this, see here. This example you take. So in this example, what is happening? So here you see. One by one we have to check. Okay? So first one, is it cycle or not? Yes, it is a cycle. Okay, done. Now here you see this. Is it planar or not? Yes, it is a planar. Why? Here see, all are involving in the sp2 hybridization. It's a planar. So why? Because this boron also involving in the sp2 hybridization. Is it clear? Next. Third one. Is it involving in the conjugation? Yes, it is involving in the conjugation. How can I say it is involving in the conjugation? If it is involving in the sp2 hybridization, this boron is having one p orbital, empty or vacant p orbital. That empty or vacant p orbital is lying parallel to the what? These pi bonded p orbitals. Okay, these pi bonded p orbitals. So therefore, what is happening? This vacant p orbital is involving in the what? Delocalization of pi bond, like a benzene ring, you know. No, so here due to this p orbital it is involving, so it is following this conjugation also. Next one, fourth one is, what is that? Is it following Huckel's rule? No, it is not following Huckel's rule. How can I say? Because it is having only two pi bonds. These two pi bonds in the delocalization, whatever. Two pi bonds means how many pi electrons? Four pi electrons. Have you got it or not? Okay, four pi electrons means which are not equal to Huckel's rule. So overall we can say it is a what? Anti-aromatic compound. You can take like this. Anti-aromatic compound. Is it clear? Any doubt in this? So this is about our today's class regarding aromatic compounds, non-aromatic compounds and anti-aromatic compounds. So with a different concept, we will meet again. Till then, bye.